It was about 1 week into summer vacation, and ever since school got out, I would go to my favorite coffee shop and work on some stories I was writing. I always sat in my favorite spot over by the window with my favorite drink. One day, while I was writing, I noticed this boy sitting across from me. I noticed because I could feel him looking at me, but every time I look at him, he looked away. Day after day, he would be in the same spot across from me, reading a book and constantly glancing at me. At first, I was kind of weirded out by it, but as time went on, I kind of started to like it, and I would smile back at him. But at the same time, wonder what he was thinking. We became these two smiley dorks who wanted to say something to each other, but we couldn't find the words. One day, he finally talked to me.
Excuse me, if you don't mind me asking, what drink is that? I see you with it almost like every time. Must be really good.
Oh, it's a caramel macchiato.
Well, I think I'll try next time.
Yeah, you should. It's really good.
Oh, by the way, I'm Travis.
I'm Shay.
So is Starbucks like your favorite coffee shop or something?
Yes, is that obvious?
Yeah.
Yeah, I like to come here to work on my stories.
Oh, cool. What do you write about?
Life, friends, love, school, stuff like that.
Oh, cool. I hope I get to read one day. Well, it's been nice talking to you, but I think I should keep going. Bye.
The next day, when I went to the coffee shop, I was hoping to see Travis. I feared that I might have scared him off the previous day because I was hardly talking. I sat down at my table and tried to brainstorm some new story ideas, but all I could think about was Travis, 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 and how he wasn't in the spot across from me. I asked myself so many questions like, will he come? Does he hate me? Will I ever see him again? Did I ruin something that could have been? I didn't know what to think. I mean, I didn't really know him, but I still missed him for some reason. He made my day interesting and he gave me these nervous but happy feelings. After I got situated at my table, I went to go get my drink, and when I got up and turned around, there was, he was holding two caramel macchiatos.
Did you
get
this?
No, you didn't have to.
I wanted to. Might I have to sit down?
Sure. Well, try it.
Wow, that's really good.
I told you.
Strangely, that day wasn't as awkward as the previous one. We laughed and talked for hours. We exchanged numbers and social medias and just started getting to know each other. Weeks and weeks passed and we started hanging out in the park. It started becoming my favorite part of the day.
I was trying to fly, but I couldn't find wings. But you came along and you changed everything. You lift my feet off the ground. You spin me around. You make me crazier, crazier. Feels like I'm falling and I'm lost in.
We had so much fun just spending time with each other. We could just talk for hours naturally about nothing. While we were talking one time, I suddenly realized we were sitting really close. And the moment he smirked, I knew he was gonna kiss me. That summer was really special.
I'd never gone with the wind, just let it flow. So much more, I'd never seen it before. I was trying to fly, but
When we shit, though I pass it through the chance, cause we know you stay lit. 2 months ago, you did.
For everybody's sake, please get off.
Oh my god!
It looks like you're pole dancing. Okay? Does kindergarten count?
No, those little kindergarten things.
When we kiss in the playhouse? No.